What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo and part four of our OSD Cloud mini series. And today is all about creating multiple OSD Cloud templates. So let's get right into it. All right. So creating multiple OSD Cloud templates, why should you do this? Because once you create one, you're good to go. No, not really. I think it's best practice to have multiple templates, one for production, one for development, one for testing, one for public, which a later on video, I'm going to tell you all about public, and, you know, one for Wi-Fi, wireless stuff, which you are able to embed Wi-Fi drivers into your template, which again, that's going to be a later video. So many videos dealing with OSD Cloud. So open up your Windows PowerShell ISE. As a full administrator, I love using PowerShell. This is one of the best utilities ever because you're learning PowerShell. First command that we need to do is run the following. This will actually get you the current OSD Cloud template that you have, okay? Once you run this, it's going to tell you your current template. Right now, the current template is the default. Throughout this entire mini series, we only created one template, and this is what we have here. Now, let's create a new template. Now, to do that, we're going to run the following command. New OSD Cloud template. With a switch of name, open and close single quotations, and whatever name you want your template. For me, BTNHD Productions. So once you run this, it's gonna do its thing, it's gonna create its thing, and once you're done, you're done. Open up your File Explorer, go inside the C drive, go into Program Data. Again, this folder is hidden. Hopefully you guys know how to unhide folders, but go into the Program Data folder, go into the OSD Cloud, and within here, go into the templates folder. Within templates, you're going to see your new template that we created. Awesome. Now, you're probably saying to yourself, where is the one that we created at the very beginning of this miniseries? Now, that is considered your default one because you did not provide a name to it. It becomes your default. That's kind of hidden and it's embedded within the OSD Cloud infrastructure. But once you give it a new name, it actually gets created inside the templates folder. Now, back inside PowerShell, if you run Git OSD Cloud Template, if we run that again, it's actually going to tell you BTNHD production. That's what it told me. It's not going to tell you BTNHD, but it's actually going to default to whatever you created. So whatever OSD Cloud Template that you create, that becomes your current template. That becomes your default template. Now, if you run Git OSD Cloud template names, that gives you a list of all your templates that you have. For me, I only have default, which is the one that we created in part one, or part one or part two, and then the one that we just created, which was BTNHD production. Now, you are able to switch between your templates by running the following command, set OSD Cloud template with a switch of name, and then you're able to actually hit the tab on your keyboard. And it will actually tell you all your templates. So once I hit the tab, it's going to jump over to my BTNHD. And if you run this command, that becomes your default one. Awesome. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.